This is the age of a new breed of follers, buckers, skinners, choker setters. And he comes with an army of foresters, logging engineers, cruisers, tree markers, and other scientists, armed with barometers, binoculars, microscopes, surveying instruments, thermometers, relief maps, and test tubes. The industry has learned the value of wood. Half the forest is no longer left in vast windrows of slash. The little trees and the limbs of the big ones now go to the pulp mills, and reforestation follows harvesting of the timber crop. Fallers on a flimsy springboard as they hacked out an undercut in rhythmic strokes for as long as 3 days has given way to the chatter of the gasoline chainsaw. Within as short a time as 10 minutes, the tree comes down. Methods of logging have revolutionized the life of the logger, and the tradition of single men and bunkhouses has been replaced by the permanent community. These are the loggers of today, living with and caring for the forests of tomorrow. The old-timer would find it hard to believe that some loggers belong to the Board of Trade, the Elks, or the Junior Chamber of Commerce, or the PTA. As a way of life, there is no similarity between the so-called romantic logger and today's scientific log harvester. Man has moved in on the forest to harvest his own crop. From it comes the pulpwood that provides us with paper, rayon, linoleum, fiberboards, hardboards, insulation, and many plastics. The saw logs that provide lumber, structural timbers, veneer, which may be further manufactured into houses, boxes, furniture, and a great variety of other products. Our uses of the tree have progressed from untold wastage to full utilization. and our civilization has progressed from the primitive to the highly developed. The incredible forest is very much a part of our society.